In this video, I'll show you how to potentially get millions of views by trend hacking, and I'll do that based on an example of the currently trending topic of the Trump shooting, the attempted assassination on the former president of the United States, Donald Trump. And trend hacking basically is about leveraging on a massively trending topic to get traffic that you wouldn't get just from ordinary, excuse me, just from ordinary Google searches, just from ordinary organic search. And you might not consider it maybe ethical or something like that to leverage on a topic that is unfortunate. However, you need to look at it from the perspective of the people searching for the content, because they are looking for as much information as they can on the topic. And your role is to provide that information. And if you get massive traffic out of it, it's worthwhile for you to do it. So, and let me show you why you wouldn't get this amount of traffic just from organic search. It can skyrocket your blog, because for example, when you look at the term, this is Google Trends, and when you look at the term Donald Trump, ordinarily, as you can see, for the past 12 months, the amount of, let's say, interest on Donald Trump has been very far below what it is right now in the past few weeks, in the past few days. And you can see if there was no trending issue, you would never get the amount of interest that is coming in the past few days. And that's just one part of it. The other part is that, for example, let's say there are millions of searches on Donald Trump each month in the ordinary search, then once the event, an event like what happened recently happens, the searches turns to tens of millions, hundreds of millions. And you find maybe there are only maybe 100,000 articles on Donald Trump before. Once the major event happens, that means there is a very big deficit of content online. It turns that trending topic into a very strategic opportunity to capture search engine result pages that never existed before, and that even the major content publishers have probably not even ventured into, especially if you do it tactfully. So I'll show you how to do it in a tactful way, not just by reporting the news or reporting the incident, but by customizing it to your specific niche so that you don't break out of your niche. And I'll show you that by demonstrating. I'll just pick, I've opened up this page with, which covers 2000, about 2000 niches. And I'll just pick any niche, various niches at random, and show you how you can cover this trending topic in different niches so that you can get an idea of how to do it. So this will give you an opportunity to capture that traffic. So let me just pick out one. I had one in mind. One was fashion. Let's say you are a fashion blogger. Yeah, you write about clothes. You can decide to maybe investigate what is the type of attire that the Secret Service wears that makes it useful for them to operate in such emergency situations, because they need to be very agile, but they are wearing suits. Are they in the normal suits? You can cover that in fashion, and that would be very appropriate for fashion. And you can even see when you check the categories, you'll notice that people are searching for the topic even in categories that are beyond politics. Let's check for fashion here. I think fashion is under beauty and fitness. Let's see. Okay. I think I think the search is, it does not have a specific option right now. Maybe my network is down or something like that. But when you check for the categories, you'll notice that there is interest even in categories that are not under politics. So that, and even if there are, you can still, even if there are no, there is no interest in those categories, when you create content that is relevant to the trend and also to your niche, you'll capture people who are searching for that trend, but who are also your audience, such that they don't need to go to other blogs to find out about something related to your niche. And so fashion was one example I've checked. Let's try. Okay, this example here is cryptocurrency. Maybe you might consider that there could have been an effect in the cryptocurrency market during the incident. Maybe you might track the changes. Maybe there are some significant changes. Maybe the Bitcoin value went up or down or something like that. Or maybe the shooter, maybe who was it? Thomas Crooks, Thomas Matthew Crooks. Maybe he had something to do with cryptocurrency. Maybe he was doing something with it. Maybe he was, there could be very many issues involved there. And let me get another one. I'll just pick at random. Just and then here is this is about diet. Is maybe you're covering, your niche is in diet, maybe it's in food. So you might ask yourself, maybe what was Matthew Crook's last meal, something like that, because he passed away once he was shot. Or maybe what is the diet that the Secret Service maybe they implement, or something like that, something that has to be very close to the trend. And because when people are searching about the Trump shooting, they'll be searching about related topics like the Secret Service. They'll be searching about the town, the specific town where the Trump rally was, the state, so many issues. So you can cover that. Then let's pick another niche, exercise and fitness. This one seems quite easy to figure out. Exercise and fitness, what is the fitness level of those Secret Service agents? Who are they physically fit? Maybe you might assess their photos and determine maybe their BMI just by looking at the photos or something like that. So that can be an something you can do. Another niche, let's say fashion. I've covered fashion, gardening, and lawn care. So could there be something related to gardening and lawn care? Because there was a Trump rally, and the location, how was it maintained? Or was there some certain considerations that the security agencies were required to consider about how the area was tended? Maybe they had to remove some trees for better visibility, or they have to position certain vegetation that they have to consider the position of certain vegetation or something like that. So or could have been, maybe it could have been that there was a hindrance to their movement, maybe if the lawn wasn't taken care of properly or something like that. So that's gardening. What about sorry, excuse me. What about health? Health, you might consider the health of Donald Trump after the incident. Could it affect his health? Maybe could you assess how people react in an instance when someone is shot at? What happens to their body? Is there something, how their biology reacts, something like that? Or could people require some, maybe, therapy? The people who were in the rally, the audience, and Trump himself, could he require therapy or something like that? Because once you encounter a life and death situation like that, you would need, you might need some help. So you can cover that and health. So you can do that. Then another niche, let's see, music and instruments. Music and instruments. So I wonder what you can do with that. There's some niches where you have to be quite creative in figuring out what you can write, but music and let's say music and instruments, there were various audio equipment being used. In fact, like even the communication devices that the security agents were using, could there have been some interference with the audio, maybe the speakers that they had to use in the rally? What are the considerations that they use when determining that? There was even a particular song that was being broadcasted during the rally. You could examine that. There could be something you could say about that. So there could be quite a few things. Maybe there are some songs that someone has already compiled right now concerning the event. You never know. So you can research that and write about it, so in your blog. So then here, pets and animals. For pets and animals, I can recall there was a mention by some news reporting agency about pets, whether they were used or not used during the event. Maybe the security agents never used them, because they usually have sniffer dogs and something like that. So you might investigate something to do with that. So, and you don't have to make the post political. You just have to evaluate something that is within your niche and is relevant to your audience. And they are already searching. So, because your audience is most likely searching, and if you combine your niche with the trending topic, you get something that your audience would actually want to read. And you can also get on Google Discover beyond just the normal Google search engine result page, because on Google Discover, trending topics can perform quite well. And there you'll get much more traffic, because Google will be placing you on the home page that people check on their phones when they are on their phones. So you can do that. Another one is technology and gadgets. Yeah, technology and gadgets, that's an easy one to figure out, because there are many communication devices used by the security agents. So you can analyze what they had, and there's a lot you can cover under that. So let's see another one. Let me see what else you can find here. Okay, this is just a list. Let me see. Travel, adventure, and holidays. Okay, this is another challenging one. Because that's about leisure, and maybe for that you might consider the travel restrictions, maybe that might apply following that incident, because previous incidents, major incidents like major incidents that could have led to some travel restrictions. Or maybe even Matthew Crooks in that Trump shooting could have traveled to certain locations. You can research on that and see what you can come up with. And there are many other ways you can cover this topic. Maybe if your blog is about historical events, you can compare how this incident was handled compared to other historical similar incidents. So there's quite a lot you can do for very many niches. And once you do that, you can provide content to your target audience and get massive traffic. And this might not be, this is not a one-time thing that you can do and get traffic with just one blog post. You might have to write several blog posts, it might be well suited for maybe someone who already has traffic. If you already have traffic, it will be even easier for you, because you leverage on the existing traffic that you have, and that can boost your website, and it can get you a lot more traffic than you would ever get just by normal SEO. So, and if you continuously do it with every new trending topic, you can consistently get a lot more views, and make a lot more money, maybe through adverts, or you can even create certain services or products. In fact, if you are doing e-commerce or something like that, you can use it to promote your e-commerce services. That's what you can do. And if you want help with that, you can check the link in the description, because I have a service that can whereby I can create content for you using this strategy. So check the link in the description and I'll help you with that. So that's all for now, and I'll see you in the next one.